works.
Oh, yeah. 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 No, I the schedule's pretty tight, so, you know, I kind of know, you know, every day what needs to get done that day to make sure that everything is
But you
delivered.
Plot the book out before you start
oh,
to
yes,
write.
Oh, yes, definitely. I outline very yeah. much so. Yep.
Working with your husband alone?
Mm-hmm. My husband and I kind of do a lot of conversations. So a lot of the books we talk about for years, like the one we just sold, we'd been working on for about three years. And then we kind of go back and forth. I do a lot of the writing, you know, and he kind of does, you know, a lot of the talking, you know, so we kind of do that together.
Yeah. But that's apart from his being an architect.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Does he draw out what's going to be in the book?
He does. He's illustrated some of my books.
Uh-huh.
He illustrated one of the Blue Bloods books.
Yeah.
And I think we'll have some illustrations for the new one, too.
Mm-hmm. What about for this? For
this one, he didn't do any drawings for it, but we did the magic together. He's kind of my fantasy, my fantasy guy.
Yeah. Talk about, again, the magic and how it worked in this book, because Freya also comes up with love potions.
Oh, yes. Because each of the witches is actually a goddess. So Freya is the goddess of love. So anything that she can make, you know, she can read people's sexual history, which is kind of interesting. And she can also, you know, make you fall in love, make you fall out of love, you know, put two people together who don't need to be.
Okay. How did you meet your husband?
Oh, we met at a party in Brooklyn. He and was at Columbia also. He was in architecture school.
And then when were you married?
And then we were together for a long time. We were married 2002 in New York. Yes.
Because, again, the romantic part of you. Yes.
Yeah, you know, I mean, maybe a lot of the guys that I write about, you know, are almost kind of based on, you know, boys that I've loved. So definitely my husband kind of figures in some of them.
Yeah. Was he a Killian?
Probably not.
More Bran?
Probably more Bran.
Yeah. Well, of course, you have one scene that I thought, now, why didn't Freya get more upset about this? That's when she comes to New York and goes to that party, and he's supposedly in Asia.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and she catches him. Yeah. I think she was kind of knew what was going on. I don't want to give too much away, which is why, you know, she's a little not as upset as, you know.
All right. But the point is, someone you love and you're engaged to, and he hasn't told you he's back in town. Come on.
Yeah, he's lying. So I think she's already deeply suspicious on many levels.
Yeah. The way the book ends, you obviously are doing a sequel.
Yes.
Were you aware you would be doing a sequel as you sat and wrote this one?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. They had bought two books, so and they had bought it as a series, so there's kind of the, I guess, the anticipation there'll be more. And, you know, I kind of... with Blue Bloods, we have about seven novels and two companions. And Witches, I kind of saw as more an open-ended series, like Charlene Harris's Sookie Stackhouse. Yeah, I think those are 13 books now. So, you know, so kind of a long, you know, story.
Do you know how it's going to end eventually?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I always know how the series is going to end. You know, I don't start a series without knowing.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always know. Blue Bloods, I've been writing that series for about 7 years, and I've known 7 years ago how it's going to end. Yeah. So.
Have you ever met the lady who wrote Harry Potter?
No, but I would love to. She seems wonderful.
Is there a world of young adult writers who get together?
Yes, we are all, you know, if not friends, pretty friendly. It's a really friendly, tight-knit community.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Now the other part is there the same financial payback for young adult novel as there is for writing this? As we know, you're now on the bestseller list with this.
Oh, the Blue Bloods have been on the bestseller list for a long time.
But that's
time.
For young adults, not for...
Oh, they count it now in USA Today and New York Times. And actually, all the biggest books are in the YA world. So, yeah. Financially, the YA world is very lucrative.
Very interesting. Mm-hmm. Now, none of those have gone into TV yet.
No, no. Yeah, we've been working on them. We've come close on several of the series, but, you know, it's Hollywood.
Yeah. What do you read?
I actually read a lot of contemporary fiction. You know, whatever everybody's reading, I'll read. I like to read the bestsellers. I like to read a lot of lady novelists, I call them.
Yeah.
Lionel Shriver, Cheryl Mendelson. But I also read, you know, I read Girl with a Dragon Tattoo. I like to read what other people are reading.
What did you see in that Girl with the Tattoo?
I had no idea it was all about sex crimes.
Yeah.
You know, I had not at all read any of the reviews. It was not really mentioned. It was more the Scandinavian and the mystery. And I thought it was a little, kind of gross, actually. I didn't like it.
Yeah. There's a wonderful, I believe she's Norwegian, who writes murder mysteries. And I was surprised I didn't, it's again, seeing their world translated into yours.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah.
Tell me about Manila. Are there good writers there?
I you know, I don't really keep up with
The Philippines.
The Philippine culture, you know. Definitely, we had, you know, our, you know, the writers that we learn in school, but it didn't seem to be a very bookish culture when I grew up in it.
Yeah, you
know? I mean, most of the books we read came from America or England, you know.
So, mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it's an interesting world. And this, of course, with the Witches of East End, great cover, and has an interesting flair.
Thank you.
Yeah.
No, it was fun to do the cover. You know, we actually had a different cover with a cat on it. It was like a little cat in a purple background.
Pie Wicket, is that the cat from? Yes.
But we thought that it didn't quite look like, you know, one of my books, which always have a girl on them. So,
will you bring in any of your experiences from having worked for banks, etc., into your books?
Not quite yet, you know. Probably not, because I kind of write fantasy, you know. Maybe if I was writing satire.
Only satire.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I think when you write about corporate America, you know, you're either going to, if you have to write about it, you know, you gotta have to make fun of it a little.
But
like Office Space.
Yeah, but you were in it during the crash and everything that happened.
Oh, no. I was
you
out
weren't,
of it, yeah.
You were out of it by then.
Yeah.
As it happened, what did you think?
Of the crash?
Yeah. And the Madoff scandal.
Yeah, you know. I mean, I worked at, I think, where were we at? We were at Bankers Trust, which is no longer here. We were doing their derivative programming. And, you know, it was a really complicated, kind of crazy financial instrument. You know, they were betting on things that had no real value. I mean, they were betting on things that were above. You know, they weren't trading stocks. They were trading on what price the stock would be tomorrow. And, you know, and I thought it was a little bit crazy, you know. It was definitely a little complicated. And my dad, you know, he was an investment banker. And, you know, he was saying, you know, insider trading is kind of routine and, you know, you should never do that. I mean, I remember I was 10 years old and he told me, don't ever embezzle.
Yeah.
I was like, I have no idea.
What is embezzle?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But it was so funny, you know, just something your investment banking dad would tell you at 10, don't embezzle.
Yeah. But derivatives became a very dangerous investment.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I was too low down the totem pole. I just programmed the formula, you know.
Yeah.
I didn't really.
What is the formula?
A lot of them were really different. I mean, I was on the futures trades. So the futures were about, you know, what the price would be. They would buy the future to make sure to set the price, you know, at a future date. And then they would make money on, you know, whatever, you know, short or long, I'm sorry. This has been so long ago.
On the difference between the come and the gone.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well,
exactly.
Witches of East End. I will look forward to the sequel because I want to know
what
happens with Frere and Killian.
Yeah. I'm writing it now.
Well, make them happy.
Yeah.
Would you autograph my
sure.
book?
Thank you,
Melissa.
Thanks so much, Connie. This is fun.
And if you'd like to know what else we've been reading, visit me on the web at www.conniemartinson.com. You can read our columns from the Beverly Hills Courier. You can also see what books we've been reading, such as Lisa C's newest book, even recently, Pinch Me, Adina Halpern's book. Very charming book. Again, Pinch Me on the happiest day of your life, and you may find yourself in a different world. Another thing, you can link in to Claremont Graduate University's Digital Library, the Peter Drucker Institute. They have archived and digitized over 1,000 of our previous shows. And there's another 1,000 they're going to be doing. Or you can link into YouTube, Connie Martinson's channel. So if you see this show but you want to see it again, it will probably be up on YouTube. Now, the most important, actually, event and part of America's history are public libraries, started by Benjamin Franklin, helped by the Carnegies, and now even the Gates are putting in computers for people to learn. But there are the books, and whatever you can do, help that librarian. Offer time, offer old books, and you'll make it a better country and yourself happier. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Connie.
Pleasure.
This was so fun.
And we'll see you next time.